Corinthians 2:9, Apostle Paul is telling the church at Corinth that eyes have not seen and ears have not heard. Amen. Concerning to the wonderful things that God wants to do for you. And I'm sharing that with you today. God has endowed us with fresh fire in this place today. Yes. Amen. There was fresh fire that came down and refilled us. God has begun to do surgery on the inside. Amen. Yes. There is no way that you could be the same. Beloved, how do you keep this fresh fire going? The word of God says that those that hunger and thirst after righteousness, that they shall be filled. Hunger and thirst after this thing. Eat the word of God. Let that be your diet. What God is saying now is that he's changing your diet. He wants you to eat on a new level because he says, I'm about to give you a new understanding. The new level is truly the new understanding that the Holy Spirit is about to reveal to you.
Yes.
He's about to take you deeper. Amen. Do you know that I walk into some pulpits and because of the anointing on the life of the shepherd, there is no depth? And I'm not talking about the pulpit itself being high or low. I'm talking about the depth in the spirit. Amen. There's certain things that you can't do when you go into certain places or you begin to offend. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. If there's no depth, then you come from a place of depth. Amen. What we want is that in the spirit realm, we want to break the floor. If there is a floor, there is no depth because the floor keeps you from going deep. Amen. We want to break every spiritual floor in our life. Amen. We want to break the ceiling because we say higher heights. Amen. God, take us higher in you. But yet and still, we get to the ceiling and we think we're going somewhere. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Glory.
But God is saying, don't settle for the height of the ceiling. He said the sky is not the limit. That you can even go higher than that. Because he says if those, hallelujah, Jesus, that are in Christ, amen, that he has seated you in heavenly places, that you are with Jesus Christ, and Jesus is in the third heaven. He's high above the same heaven. Hallelujah, Jesus. I saw Stephen. I saw it in the word of God. He pierced up into the heavens. Hallelujah, Jesus. While he was being stoned by his adversary. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. But he had compassion for the adversary. He said, Lord, hold not this charge against them. He lifted up in the heavens. He looked past the atmosphere. He looked past the clouds. He looked past the second heavens. The celestial heavens where the demons are. He looked past all of that stuff. Hallelujah, Jesus. He pierced far past the water above the firmament. And he looked into the third heavens. And he saw Jesus in the throne room. It kind of reminded me of Esther. When Esther went before the king. Hallelujah, Jesus. And when she got into the inner court, she saw the king in the throne room. Hallelujah, Jesus. But when Stephen saw Jesus, the word of God said that the king was on his feet.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
A standing Jesus. Ovation.
Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Can we read and study the word of God till we get a standing ovation from the king? All of heaven was on their feet because when the king stand,
come on now.
Everything was at attention. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to his name.
Glory.
Can we be a witness unto death until we get a standing ovation?
Yes.
Will we not love this life unto the death? Amen. Will we prefer to be with Jesus? Amen.
Fire.
Beloved, I'm talking to you about fresh fire today.
Fire.
This is not possible without the fresh fire falling upon us. The heavens bending.
Yeah.
The mountains melt. Amen. The rivers of living water within you bubbling over.
Come on now.
From the fresh fire that God has dropped in this place. Jesus. And all I'm going to tell you today is praise him.
Hey.
The word is spoken. Praise him is yours. If you magnify him, it's yours.
Fire!
Amen.